And what is magic? It is the use of your chance to gain eternal life, to become a part of the spiritual world. This very power you use to get temporary, empty and endless things. Magic is used by people in everyday life very frequently, and people don't notice this. When a person curses someone, when he hates him and wishes evil, this is already a part of magic. This should be known and understood when a person comes to some temple for communication with God, but asks for the health of his body or for that of his relatives and close people. This is also magic. When a person asks for wealth or resolution of some problem in the material world, this is magic too. Everything that relates to fulfillment in three-dimensionality of some human desires, again relating to everything material, all this is magic. A person wastes those vital forces that should be directed to perception through feelings, to the contact with the spiritual world. The person wastes them on material wealth, on fulfillment of his own desires. Consciousness is a good tool, a necessary tool, but a tool, let's say, with its own temperament. I will give a simple example. In India, they use elephants. Many people know from movies how they carry logs on their tusks and the like. But one should understand that an elephant, it identifies itself, it has a well-developed consciousness, a well-developed memory, and at any moment, just like a bear, it can become aggressive and attack. Although, since its childhood, it has been brought up to be nice and obedient. Human consciousness is the same, it is like that elephant or that bear. On the one hand, it is obedient, executes commands, but it can always attack. Therefore, one should understand this, know this. And let's say there is such an expression, to keep it on a tight leash. The very process of desiring, it is already nothing else but a magic activity. Especially when people already imagine the end result, let's say, of that very meeting tomorrow. Meaning, the game of consciousness. People don't understand that at this moment your consciousness is in the contact with his consciousness. Although the person doesn't notice that, and the consciousnesses of both of you are already making a certain decision. As a rule, they make a decision that is essential for the system. But the result is always predetermined. Yet, when you have not played out a scenario, you have not engaged in magic, you are free in this case. And here you have many more chances to win the argument, and this is not magic. This is the truth. Why? Because the system is not prepared for your action. Consciousness is like a guardian. It does everything to retain its power over personality. That's the point. And it always fragments, complicates things. As soon as it finds a weak side in a human being, for instance, a person is following the spiritual path of development, begins to feel a certain degree of freedom, and at some point in time he is distracted by something, and here consciousness rearranges everything in its own way. And the person, instead of building his future in the spiritual boundless world, he starts building temporary castles, a territory for his comfort. He starts building a place where he can manifest his power. And why? A simple question. Consciousness wants it to be so. At such time, the person doesn't even think what he will pay for it. He is enjoying and living now, but he's living by illusions. The guardian is the guardian precisely so as to let through those who deserve it. But again, what do we come to? To people's choice. People themselves want it to complicate their existence. Well, they have complicated it. But on the other hand, the more difficult was the fight. the more well-deserved is the victory.